हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नवांकुर विद्यापीठ वेलकम्स यू इन डीजी लेसन्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी स्नैपशॉट्स सप्लीमेंट्री रीडर इन इंग्लिश फॉर क्लास 11th कोर कोर्स चैप्टर द टेल ऑफ मेलन सिटी। द टेल ऑफ मेलन सिटी बाय विक्रम सेठ। द फॉलोइंग पोएम इज टेकन फ्रॉम Mappings, which was published in 1981 and is included in the collected poems by Vikram Seth. The king in this poem is just and placid. Does he carry his notion of justice a bit too far? Main points are introduction, an ancient tale, king just, place loving. Construction of the ark, orders to construct a beautiful ark on the public road to improve the look. Laborers were set to work. Ark was constructed. Ark was built low, writes on the public road. Ark was low. Ground got stuck against the ark and fell off. Unpleasantness on the face of the king fell dishonored. Arrangements were made for hanging. Decided to hang the chief of builders. They said it was the laborer's fault. Laborers said that the size of bricks was wrong. Blamed the masons. They blamed the architect. Architect reminded the king that he had made amendments to the plan. When they were shown to him, architect indirectly blamed the king. The wisest man was called. The king was confused, ordered to bring the wisest man in the country. Wisest man, old, couldn't walk nor see, was brought to the royal court. Said that the ark was the real culprit and it should be hanged. Counselor said it would be shameful to hang the ark that touched His Majesty's head. His Majesty was hanged. Crowd was getting restless. King said that someone must be hanged since the nation wanted hanging. Noose was set up. It was placed high. Each man was measured. Only one man who was tall enough to fit in it. The king, his majesty, was hanged. Love life the king, the minister said. Long live the king is dead. Problem of choosing the next ruler followed their old custom. The next to pass the city gate would choose the king. An idiot happened to pass the city gate. Guards asked him who should be the king. He replied, "A melon." This was his answer to all the questions, since he liked melons. Ministers crowned a melon. A melon king was placed at the throne. Happy kingdom. All this happened long ago. When someone asks that how is it their king appears to be a melon, it's all right if their majesty takes delight in being a melon, happy as long as there is peace and freedom. Principle of non-interference in that state. Now question answers. Narrate the tale of Melon City in your own words. You can write in your own words, but there is formal answer. The poem The Tale of Melon City is an account of an incident involving a king's wish to build an ark. His complaints regarding the faulty construction of the ark and how his decree ultimately falls on him, leading on his hanging. This humorous poem narrates the transition of crown from the king to a melon, which became a symbolic head of the state. In the beginning poem, the poet narrates, long ago there was a just and placid kind. One day he wished to construct an ark spanning the main thoroughfare to edify the spectators. After the completion of the ark, the king went to take a look at the newly constructed ark, where his crown fell off because the ark was very low. Feeling disgraced, he decided to hang the chief of builders. The chief of builders defended himself by saying that it was the laborer's fault. Convinced by the argument, the king decided to hang all the workmen. The workmen shifted all the responsibility to size of bricks. Masons were summoned. Masons would all the blame. The architect reminded the king that he had made king some changes in the plan when it was shown to him. The king was confused and hence solicited the advice of the wisest man of the country. He gave an advice that the ark is the real culprit, so it must be changed. When the process to hang the ark was going on, a counselor said that it would be very shameful to hang the ark that touched the king's crown. The crowd which gathered there to witness the hanging was getting restless, and sensing their mood, the king said that someone must be hanged. The noose was set up somewhat high. Each man was measured, but only one man was there tall enough to fit in the noose. It was the king. The king was hanged, and the ministers heaved a sigh of relief that they were able to find someone to be hanged. Otherwise, the unruly crowd might have turned against the crown. After the death of the king, the minister sent out the herald to proclaim that next to pass the city gate would choose a king. An idiot happened to pass the city gate, and his answer to all the questions was a melon. The ministers crowned a melon and placed it on the throne. The citizens were least bothered about their symbolic head as they enjoyed the principles of laissez-faire. Second, what impression would you form of a state where the king was just and placid? A state where the king was just and placid, the citizens enjoyed peace, liberty, and justice. The real governance was in the hands of the citizens. In the poem, the citizens wanted someone to be hanged, and ultimately the king was hanged. This shows that what the king was just and placid, the citizens influenced the fate of the king. How, according to you, can peace and liberty be maintained in a state? If there exists laissez-faire in a state, the principle of non-interference by the king and in the activities of the citizens, peace and liberty can be maintained. However, the government must maintain law. In order to maintain a balance between citizens' rights and government's laws. 4. Suggest a few instances in the poem which highlight humor and irony. The decision of the king to hang the chief of builders for constructing a low ark evokes laughter among us. When the king got convinced that the workmen who constructed the ark are guilty and wanted to hang them, it was humorous the way every person shifts the responsibility on other makes us laugh. Ultimately, that king was found responsible as he made amendments in the plan to build the ark. The irony of the king was when he found himself responsible and asked to be solicited. A wise man's advice. The Veda wise man blamed the ark and declared that it must be hanged was humorous. Ironically, one counselor pointed out that the ark should not be hanged, and the king thought that the crowd wanted someone to be hanged. The choice of successor is humorous, as an idiot chooses a melon to become a symbolic head of the state, and the ministers crown a melon and place it on the throne. Question number 5. The tale of Melon City has been narrated in a verse form. This is a unique style which lends extra charm to an ancient tale. Find similar examples in your language. Share them in the class. Students may attempt themselves. Thank you, students.